Yes, it's that time again. Welcome to the Rock of Ages Ministries television program, an international evangelistic ministry reaching souls around the world for Jesus, a ministry with signs and wonders, healing and deliverance, with your host, a Latter-day Apostle, a man with God's vision for today, one who's reaching out to the lost at any cost around the world for Jesus, Apostle Ronnie Bailey. Apostle Bailey is a man of God, operating in the gifts of the Spirit, healing miracles, and with a prophetic anointing upon his life. He has been called out by God to break down strongholds, break victory over drug and alcohol addicted people, poverty, generational curses, and all other spiritual bondages, to bring God's holy restoration to souls around the world. If you need prayer or counseling, please avail yourself to our prayer and counseling hotline numbers. They are 337-706-7262. That's 337-706-7262 or 504-613-7234. That's 504-613-7234. We have committed counselors, prayer counselors standing by right now to assist you around the clock at your prayer and counseling needs. Or if you would like to write this ministry, you may do so by writing Rock of Ages Ministries, 201 South College Road, Suite 214, Lafayette, Louisiana, 70503. And remember to send all your prayer requests.
Our email address is ronnie@ronniebailey.com, and our website can be accessed anytime at www.ronniebailey.com. You may also watch our telecast on our brand new webcast channel at www.vo.com/channels/Rock of Ages TV. And enjoy our telecast anytime, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week at your convenience. Now, why don't you take a moment and call a friend and let them know that the Rock of Ages Ministries television program is now on the air.
So sit back and enjoy an exciting program for the Apostle Ronnie Bailey.
I thank God forever and forever. He's my joy, my peace, my wonderful counselor. Jesus is his name.
Hallelujah. I just want to praise his name. Let's give the Lord a victory clap. Amen. And I know that you're applauding in your homes. I'm getting so many reports of how God is touching your life through this telecast and these ministers who have labored to come and to share the good news, better known as the gospel, with you. Some have come from Hammond, Louisiana. We have ministers coming from Africa, from India, and all over the world to bring you the good news of Jesus Christ. And I just like to start off with, for those of you that don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, we don't usually do this, but we're going to open up with an invitation for you to accept him right now. So if you would, if you're in your home with your family, then grab hands together and repeat this prayer with me. Say, Lord Jesus,
Lord Jesus,
I know that I'm a sinner.
Please forgive me.
Wash me in your blood.
Wash me in your blood.
Come into my heart.
Come into my heart.
Be Lord of my life. I receive you now.
I receive you now.
I know that I'm saved.
I know that I'm saved.
Right now.
Right now.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And you know, some of you may think or wonder, why did we do this so early in the telecast? Because we don't know. See, the Spirit knows all things.
Yes.
There could have been someone that was about to commit suicide. I might be speaking to someone right now. And you needed, you couldn't wait till later on, till we would have gotten around to it. Because now is the acceptable time.
Amen.
Amen. For you to receive the Lord. So we're going to move right into our telecast. Amen. If you have said that prayer, let me be one of the first to congratulate you and welcome you into the kingdom of God. Amen. And you need to call the prayer and counseling and information hotline that is on your screen and let someone know just what God has done for you today. Today's topic is operating in the fruits of the Holy Spirit. And in Galatians 5 and 22, it actually speaks of the word is fruit, operating in the fruit of the Holy Spirit. Because the reason, and you know there's nine fruits of the Holy Spirit, but the reason why Galatians says the fruit of the Spirit, amen, is because it's talking about Jesus. Mm-hmm. He is the fruit of the Spirit. And those nine gifts that goes forth, or fruits, we call them fruits, those are the attributes of Christ. And we're going to talk about those fruit, the fruit of Christ or the attributes of Christ. But be it known, Jesus is the fruit of the Spirit. Because he had every one of those attributes. Amen? And but without any further ado, if you need prayer counseling, please avail yourselves to the prayer and counseling information hotline. You may visit our website 24 hours a day, 7 days a week at www.RonnieBailey.com. And also, if you'd like to drop us an email, you can drop us an email at Ronnie@RonnieBailey.com. And we want to welcome our first guest, praise God, woman after God's own heart who needs no introduction because she's pretty much on all of our telecasts, Pastor Rachel Harrison of God's Loving Hands Ministries. Welcome once again.
Amen. Praise the Lord, everybody.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord, the yes. living God.
Yes.
I just want to thank God for being here today. As Apostle say, my name is Pastor Rachel Harrison, God's Loving Hands Ministry, working also along with To the Glory of God Ministry. It was so fitting, Apostle, that you open up with salvation.
Amen.
Because I tell you, in order for them to have the fruit of the Spirit, they must have Jesus.
Yes.
There's no other way than you can work with the fruit of the Spirit without having Christ. As he spoken earlier in Galatians 5:22, I'm going to read it. It says, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, gentleness, goodness, faith, and we can't leave out 23. Meekness, temperance. Against such there is no law.
Amen.
When we got these fruits operating in our lives, we are not going to do anything wrong. Right before you get to the fruit of the Spirit, God is so awesome in his direction for us, the roadmap that we have, the Bible. He also laid out what the Antichrist has operating. Beside the fruit of Spirit, if you're not working in the fruit of the Spirit, you're working in other things. What? Murder, envy, strife, backbiting, drunkenness, revelness. All of these are the fruit of the Antichrist.
Mm.
So if you're not working in the fruit of the Spirit, you're working in the fruit of the Antichrist, your father. So it was so fitting that you put out the invitation that they accept Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. Now they will be able to walk
That's
in the
right.
fruit of the Spirit.
Amen.
Other than that, we can't walk in it. We can't do it on ourselves.
That's right.
It's not in our nature to do it. We were born in a sinful nature.
Say that.
So it's not in our nature to do what's right. But when Christ is in us, then we can do, we can walk, and we can live in the fruit of the Spirit. We can have that love. We can have that joy. We can walk in peace. Long suffering with our brothers and sisters, even though they done did us something, and we can have that forgiveness because we have Christ that live in us.
Mm-hmm.
Besides that, we can't do it. So if you accepted Christ as your personal Savior a few minutes ago, or you have accepted him in the past, we can walk in that fruit.
Amen.
His fruits are true.
Yes.
Let's walk in love.
Yes.
The greatest of them all is love. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Glory to God. No, that was well put. If you're not walking in the fruit of the Spirit, then you're walking in the fruit of the flesh.
Amen.
Is that right?
Amen.
And the Bible says that we must walk in the Spirit lest we fulfill the lusts of
That's
the flesh.
It.
So we just thanking God. Look like we didn't went into Romans, the 8th chapter. So we're going to stay back in Galatians. And we're going to welcome our next guest. Amen. And this will be his television debut with us, so we'd like him to introduce himself in his own way. But his name is Apostle Arendelle Yearwood, and he's of Church of Full Deliverance.
Total Deliverance.
Full Deliverance. Amen. Whole Deliverance?
Total Deliverance.
Total Deliverance. Amen. Well, we want to welcome you at this time, and it's our pleasure for you to be one of our guests. Praise God.
Good evening. Mm-hmm. It's a pleasure to be here on this broadcast for the first time.
Yes.
Coming to you to let you know that Jesus Christ is Lord.
Mm-hmm. Yes, he is.
And in order for you to understand and to know who he really is, you have to. It is not a maybe. It is not a I think I might. But you have to operate in the fruit of the Spirit. Because Jesus Christ, when he came to this earth, when he was baptized by John, and his father sent his dove down with the Spirit, it showed us that in order for us who are called by his name to operate and do the things that he has left us here to do, we must operate in the Spirit. We must have the fruit of the Spirit. And as Pastor Rachel said, she quoted Galatians 5:22. But I'm going to deviate from that and go and tell you, say, report to you Galatians 5:16.
All right.
This I say, walk in the Spirit.
Come on.
And ye shall not fulfill the lusts of the flesh. You see, walking in the Spirit takes away from your fleshly or your earthly things.
Say that now.
You must remember you are a spirit. You are the Spirit of God living in a fleshly, earthly body.
Right.
And in order to get closer to God, you have to operate in the flesh. Not in the flesh, but in the spirit.
That's right.
You have to get away from lustful things.
That's right.
Like cursing, swearing, stealing, drunkenness. All these things you have to get away from in order to get closer to God.
That's right.
Must operate in the fruit of the Spirit.
Amen.
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 Praise God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Can we give a Lord a hand? Thank God for our live studio audience. Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
And we thank God for you. Mm-hmm. So I really enjoyed that, Apostle Arendelle. And I believe you say it's Church of Total Deliverance. Amen. Praise God. And I tell you, I could feel that anointing coming forth as you were sharing and expounding on God's Word. Praise the Lord. So we want to thank God. We had a beautiful Good Friday service over in Hammond, Louisiana. Mm-hmm. And we have the angel of that church here with us. We only have about 5 minutes before we take our break. And like I said, she only need a good hot minute, her. She can put enough in there for an hour and 1 minute. But anyway, she need no introduction as well. Prophetess Grace Bickham, welcome us.
Amen.
Again.
Welcome.
Thank you.
Amen.
Thank you.
As we celebrated the Good Friday, love came down from heaven on Friday, and on Sunday we all celebrated and we thank God. And without the fruit of the Spirit, that wouldn't have been possible, because we know that John 3:16 says, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on him shall not perish but have everlasting life. We're talking of the fruit of the Spirit, which is the Holy Spirit, God's active love and work within and through us, and then it covered the spirit in us. And normally we say by ourselves we can do nothing, but with him we can do all things. And it means what? To supplement the fruit. If we keep on eating the plant, love, faith, kindness, peace, all goes together. And remember, we are one and we are serving the same God.
Yes.
And it gives us the fiber. When you say fruit of the spirit, that means the fruit that came down so that we can grab it and eat it and enjoy it and have peace and have happiness. And always remember, what does the work and the empowerment of the fruit of the spirit really mean to us? The fruit of the spirit is described as the fruit because he made out of more than one substance. Remember, the core, the segment, the skin, all goes together. And without the leaves, there will be no fruit. Without the skin, there will be no fruit. So all works together. That tells us the ministers of God, different churches, we have to work together in love and in unity. And without faith, it is impossible to please God. So always remember, all faith, all abide together. Yes. Remember, so it is the fruit of the spirit. God made it as it requires us to grow in faith, and also the necessity of us to attain to him. And remember, it is the substance of things that we don't even see, and evidence of things that is about to happen.
Yes.
So when you start trusting in God and believing in him, so the fruit of the spirit is the continual and indispensable application of God's work in our lives. And what are we thinking? Are we thinking right? If we don't have the fruit of the spirit in us, are we preaching if the spirit of God is not in us? I mean, we are wasting time. Remember, the loss of eyes, the loss of flesh, and the pride of this world is what separates us from God.
That's
so
right.
Remember, the fruit of the spirit is the spirit that God has given to us. We have to believe, we have to hold on to this fruit. Peace, joy, kindness, and remember, long suffering is very, very important. So by ourselves we can do nothing, but with God we can do all things. I, the prophetess of God, I know that without the fruit of God in me, I wouldn't be able to operate anything, because most of the time that I sit down, the fruit will just come, and I will take it and I will eat it, and the life of God will be in me, and I'll be able to share it with you. So I want you, what you're hearing today, and listen very carefully, take it along and tell others and give them the fruit. And what fruit are you bearing? Bear the fruit that others will pick it up and eat it and share with others. God bless you. Don't give up. No matter what happens to you, the fruit of the spirit is love, and that love is in you. God bless you.
Yes. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Like I told you, she was going to have a mouthful in just a short period of time. And of course, we're going to have all of our guests back for prayer. And we just want to go to this beautiful song. By the way, thank you, prophetess. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I tell you, the anointing is in the studio.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Amen. And we're going to this beautiful song. And you're going to hear from this young man a little later on in the telecast. But right now, we're going to go to this important message. And this song, In the Spirit, by the way, from Apostle Michael Hammond. And we'll be back in just a moment.
Amen.
To visit Rock of Ages Ministries on the web, just type into your web browser www.ronniebailey.com. You may click on links such as missions, TV schedule, sermon of the month, contact us, national, international, and slideshow galleries, just to name a few. Please add your contact information so that we can add your name to our mailing list. We would like to have the opportunity of following up with you in the future. For our international visitors, just click on your country's flag symbol located on our home page. This will change our entire website to the language of your choice. It's just that easy. Also, don't forget to sign our guest book. You may also insert your picture and comments if you choose as well. If you need prayer or counseling, please complete the information form below. One of our prayer counselors will respond as soon as we receive your request. We are committed to assisting you with your most earnest needs.
My soul loves Jesus. Amen. Hallelujah. Glory to God. I know that you're enjoying that beautiful song by Apostle Michael Hammond, Michael G. Hammond, and he's in the studio. We're going to hear from him in just a little bit. But if you need prayer counseling, please avail yourselves to the prayer and counseling information hotline that's on your screen anytime during and or thereafter. Praise God. The telecast is complete because we have our prayer counselor standing by right now to receive your calls. And without any further ado, we want to go to the man of God that is a man after God's own heart. Amen. And his name is Apostle Alvin Daniels. Praise God, a United Church of Total Deliverance also. Praise God. Welcome. Amen. Give God some praise. Thank you, Jesus. Now, Apostle Daniels, what I'd like you to do, just introduce yourself briefly and tell us what you can sow into our spirit about the fruit of the Spirit.
Amen. We praise God for this opportunity, amen, to be in your midst. We thank God for, amen, allowing us, amen, this opportunity to be here with you on today. I'm excited. Something I hear my wife says all the time, I'm excited. You know, I've been preaching for a long time, but today, for some reason, I'm just excited.
Amen.
But amen, we thank God, amen, for United Church of Total Deliverance, where yours truly is founder, amen, and overseer.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord has blessed us.
Thank you, Jesus.
We come this way by, amen, North Carolina. Amen. Praise God. We've been here in the city about 6 years now, and God is doing a great work. Amen. Man, give no glory to the flesh. Amen. But to God be the glory for the great things that He has done. Amen. Praise God. Since we've been here. Amen. Praise God. I want to say, Apostle Bailey, what I heard one of my kids say in our vacation Bible church school, and I could get away with that, and I wouldn't have to say anything, and I agree with everything that everybody else has said. Amen, but I can't get away with that. So you know, I thank God for the fruit of the Spirit, because when I think about love, I used to hear the old preacher say, it was not the nails that kept him on the cross, but it was love.
Mm-hmm.
I believe when we got the love, that agape love, But when we're talking about the fruit of the Spirit, when we got that love, I like to say that real love, that R-E-A-L love, when we got that type of love, we can accomplish the things that God have called us to do.
Yes.
But until we get that agape love, that was the love that God had when he sent his only son to die for my sin. I didn't deserve it. Amen. Yes. But when he sent his son to die for my sin, that was love.
That's
and
right.
When I think of that type of love, then I'm able to love my neighbor as myself.
Well,
I'm able to love my enemies in spite of, amen.
That's all right.
I'm able to walk with those, amen, praise God, who don't want to walk with me, amen, praise God. I'm able to give all of myself, amen, praise God, that God will receive the glory out of what I do, amen. So I thank God for the fruit of the Spirit of love, amen. I know that joy and peace and happiness and all those things come with it, but that L-O-V-E plays a big part in my life, because until I start loving myself, I couldn't love anybody else. Until I started knowing that God truly loved me, I couldn't even love my wife. Amen. More or less talking about loving the church. But when I realized that it was love that kept Jesus on the cross, amen, I was able to walk, amen, in the fruit of the Spirit.
Thank you, Jesus.
Glory be to God.
Let's give God some praise for that. As we're getting ready to go on to our next guest, you know, the Spirit just quickened me of this one passage that Jesus said, you will know them by their fruit. Amen. You know, everybody is getting excited and all fired up about the gifts of the Spirit. Amen. Which we had a telecast recently. But the word says, you will know them by their fruit. Amen.
Amen.
The fruit of the Spirit is love and all the nine fruits of the Spirit. And if this person, as 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter, said, you know, if they have all those gifts and all that power, but they have not charity or have not love, they're nothing.
Hallelujah.
Amen. But without any further ado, let's welcome a young man. He's also doing his television debut with us. And he has a pretty long name. Sometimes I have to kind of think about it myself. Pastor DeAndre S. Granberry, Sr. And not only does he have a big name, but he has a big anointing that's upon his life. Hallelujah. I want to welcome him at this time. And he's of Holy Garment Tabernacle. Tell us a little bit about your ministry, and let's go into the fruit of the Spirit.
Amen. Praise God, everybody. First, indeed, I want to give honor to God. Amen. The Spirit of the Lord that's in the place.
Yes.
I can feel
Hallelujah.
God's anointing to Apostle Ronnie Bailey, the prophet and visionary of this very fine ministry. God placed an anointing on our lives, amen, at a very early age, at the age of 12, amen, prophesying, preaching, and teaching the word of God. And we thank God, amen, there's a lot of things that we didn't have to go through by getting saved at a young age, amen. There's still some stuff that we got to go through, but I thank God there's a lot of things that I was able to bypass, amen, by being saved at a
That's
young
right.
age.
Right.
Amen. Again, I'm going straight into the word. Galatians 5, I'm going to read it to you, verses 22 through verses 26, which declares, but the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, long-suffering, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, self-control. Against such there is no law. And those who are Christ have crucified the flesh with his passions and desires. If we live in the Spirit, let us also walk in the Spirit. Let us not become conceited, provoking one another, envying one another. And God's word is blessed. Amen. One thing that I believe is that we are living in the last days. The Bible declares that the last days are perilous times. Perilous times meaning difficult times, uneasy times, unpredictable times, and hard times. Amen. I believe that these are the times where God is going to begin to fill our churches and our ministries like never ever before. I believe that people are going to run into our churches because they're going to be under the anointing. Amen. And I believe that the only way that we are going to be able to keep these last days souls is that we've got to begin to operate in the fruits of the Spirit.
Yes.
Amen. We cannot begin to walk after the flesh and begin to keep these last day souls. Amen. I believe that one way that we have to walk after the Spirit, amen, is we have to let flesh die. Amen. A lot of times we put flesh to rest and bring it back up again, but flesh have to cease. Flesh have to die. Amen. Flesh have to decrease so the Spirit and in us can begin to increase.
That's right.
Amen. This is the time now where God wants us to begin to walk after the Spirit so we can, amen, begin to bring miracles back into our churches.
Yes, yes,
miracles and healing have left the church because there are a lot of us that are walking after the flesh.
Hallelujah.
But this is the time now, this is the season where God is going to begin to fill our churches out because he said in the last days, your son and your daughters are going to begin to prophesy. Amen. I want to let our flesh decrease.
Yes,
let
sir.
The Spirit man in us begin to increase, and we got to feed ourselves the Word of God. That's the way, amen, that you defeat the flesh is by feeding your Spirit the Word of God. Amen. I reminded that when Jesus was in the wilderness, amen, every time the devil came up against him, he fed the devil the Word of God.
Yes,
he kept on saying, as it is written, and it is written. Amen. So we got to continue to let the devil know what the Word says, and amen, the devil will be defeated, flesh will decrease, and our spirit will begin to increase.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. A rhema word.
Hallelujah.
A rhema word from heaven. Praise God. And I believe you're going to be having an event real soon. Could you just take just a few seconds or about a minute and just let us know about this next upcoming event?
June the 3rd through June the 5th, all roads will lead to 4200 Old Gentilly Road in New Orleans. Amen. We will be having our birthday celebration Friday night, June the 3rd. Apostle Bailey will be bringing the word. Amen. He'll also be officiating our ordination service June the 4th and June the 5th. All services are at 7 o'clock p.m. Pastor Harold L. Thomas from Detroit, Michigan will be here. So again, that's 4200 Old Gentilly Road, the Motel 6 Conference Room. Meet us there, amen, because it will be a powerful, powerful 3 nights, and God will bless us all 3 nights.
Now, I know we need to give the Lord a praise for that.
Amen.
Hallelujah. And you can call the Prayer and Counsel Information Hotline for more information. Praise God. Without any further ado, let's welcome the woman of God. Amen. All the way from Slidell, Louisiana, Gulfport, Mississippi. Amen. And she's all over. Praise God. Lifting up the name of Jesus, Evangelist Jill Brendel. Introduce yourself and welcome us again.
Yeah, thank you, Pastor Bailey. Yes, I am Evangelist Jill Brendel, currently residing in Slidell, Louisiana. And yes, we're talking about operating in the fruits of the Holy Spirit today. And I'm going to add a few things to what's been said. I'm going to reiterate a few things that have been said because God, you know, has given me some of the same things I already gave an apostle and some of the others. But I'm going to start in John chapter 15. And my subtitle, New American Standard, says, Jesus is the vine and the followers are the branches. And all of us that have Jesus Christ in our hearts as Lord and Savior are followers of Jesus Christ.
Say that now.
But the first verse says, I am the true vine, my Father is the vine dresser. And when I was looking at this a few minutes ago, that word true vine jumped out. And that reminded me there are false vines, false prophets, false apostles, the false. In order to have a true, you've got to have false so you know what is true.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to make sure that we're hooked up with the true vine. We need to make sure that we're fellowshipping and our connections, our pastor and whoever that we're with, are hooked up to the true vine, are hooked up to Jesus. They're not teaching some squirrely doctrine, you know, off in the field somewhere, in other words. Verse 2, every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears fruit, he prunes it. And prunes means to cleanse, that he may bear more fruit. And how are we going to be cleansed? It tells us in verse 3, you're already clean because of the word which I have spoken to you. So if we're in the word, if we're in the word continually, if we abide in the word, as it says in the next few verses, it means to remain or stay in that word, we're going to be connected to the true vine. We're going to stay connected to Jesus. You know, we're going to have the fruit of the Spirit in our lives. We're going to have the love, the joy, the peace, the patience, the kindness, the goodness, the faithfulness, the gentleness, and the self-control. And one translation I read years ago, I don't remember the name, but it says the fruit of the Spirit is love, and it is manifested in joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. And the Lord was reminding me that Proverbs 11:30 says the fruit of the righteous is a tree of life, and he who is wise wins souls. So that fruit, that salvation, that prayer that Apostle Bailey opened this broadcast with, that is fruit right there, salvation. That's the most important fruit of the Spirit that we can have, is to be saved. Because without salvation, the rest of the fruit are not going to flow through us. We might say we love somebody, but do we really love them if we're not saved? Are we just saying something to get something, as people in the world do?
My God.
Verse 4 says, abide in me and I in you. The branch cannot bear fruit of itself unless it abides in the vine, so neither can you unless you abide in me.
Yes, Lord.
Verse 5, I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him, he bears much fruit, for apart from me can do nothing.
Yes.
Now, I believe all of us want God to say at the end of each day, well done, good and faithful servant. We don't want him to say, you didn't do what you were supposed to do today. You didn't share the gospel with that person. You didn't help that brother or sister in Christ. You didn't pray for him. So as we abide in the vine, as we stay in the Word of God,
yes,
I believe he will tell us, well done, good and faithful servant,
yes,
each day.
Yes.
Verse 6, if anyone does not abide in me, he is thrown away as a branch and dries up, and they gather them and cast them into the fire, and they are burned. I don't believe any of us want to be in that group.
Yes.
Thrown in the fire and burned. I believe that reference has a reference to our crown in heaven, and we're going to have less jewels in our crown if we're not obedient to the Lord, to the Word of God, if we're not allowing that fruit of the Spirit to flow through us. And as the Apostle said earlier, too, 1 Corinthians 13 says that if we have all these gifts in our lives,
amen,
but the fruit of the Spirit, mm-hmm, is even more important than the gifts. I would agree with what he said. If we don't have the fruit of the Spirit, the gifts, it's not going to profit us anything. We're going to be nothing. We're going to be like a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. And yes, that chapter may emphasize love, y'all, but you know what? Remember, the fruits of the Spirit all flow down through love. In verse 7, if you abide in me and my words abide in you, ask whatever you wish and it shall be done for you. If the fruits of the Spirit in our life, Psalms 37:4 says, delight yourself in the Lord and you will give, and he will give us the desires of our heart. We're not going to ask for things, y'all, if we're not in the Word. In other words, let me put it this way. We're not going to ask for things that don't line up with the Word, y'all, if we're in the Word. Okay? If we're in the Word, if we're studying the Word, if we're praying, we're not going to ask God for something that I believe does not line,
amen,
up with the Word,
amen,
of God. Because that fruit of the Spirit is in our lives. We want to love God, and we want to love people, and we want to be a blessing. So all the fruit of the Spirit, as they flow through us, as they work through our lives, they're going to allow us to win many to the Lord. Thank you.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Give God a praise for that. And we're just thanking God. Hallelujah. We're just thanking God for these messages that are going forward, you know, because you don't hear a lot about the fruit of the Spirit. And this is why this needs to be taught, because as Evangelist Jill so beautifully expressed, and she was reiterating something that I had said, you know, without the fruit, the gifts are no good. And the testimony in your life is no good, because we need more than just the gifts. We need to be an example.
Amen.
Amen. An example of Christ. So we're just thanking God today, and we're going to go to our next song. Amen. It's by the Mime Singers. Amen. I call them the Mime Singers, but I know that they have a more appropriate name. And they are also a blessing to the Outcast Ministry, Pastor Thomas Tucker's ministry. So without any further ado, we want to go to this song and this important message, and we're going to be right back with our closing note and prayer. God bless you.
Our picture gallery is also available to help acquaint you better with our ministry and the various events conducted throughout the year. You may also click on our slideshow gallery and enjoy continuous slide-by-slide, local, national, and international, on our special large screen view. Our webcast channel is available to view a library of telecasts and video, organized by picture and title for your convenience. Just click on the webcast channel of your choice by clicking on the appropriate symbol. there for you 24 hours a day and 7 days a week for your convenience. Just type www.ronniebailey.com and sit back and relax and enjoy our website. And be sure to invite your friends as well.
Hallelujah. Something about that name, Jesus. Hallelujah. And we just want to thank God. As a matter of fact, that was brought to you with the blessings of Outcast Ministry, Pastor Thomas Tucker, who you hear just a little bit from in just a minute or so. But let's just welcome our very next guest, Apostle Michael G. Hammond. Amen. Thank you for taking our time out of your busy schedule. And we really enjoyed your song earlier in the telecast.
God bless you. It's so good to be here once again. I have enjoyed all of the men and women of God that have expounded so beautifully on the fruit of the Spirit.
Amen.
And my mind go back a few years ago when I was small, younger, shall I say, being reared in the Church of God in Christ. They taught us one thing. They taught us about how to love. They taught us about the scripture, Hebrew 12 and 14, how to follow peace with all men.
Yes.
And holiness, without which no man shall see the Lord. You know, it's imperative, people of God, in this hour, that we don't fool around and have gifts without no character.
That's right.
It's very important. You have a lot of people that can prophesy. You have a lot of people that can lay hands. That don't mean anything if you can't love. Me, myself, I don't let other people prophesy to me if they can't love me. Because out the same mouth can't come blessing and cursing. We can't lift you up one day and tear you down the next day.
Yes.
It's imperative that we remain in love. I'm tired of seeing leaders that is failing to love God people.
Yes.
It's imperative that we learn how to love. Love is what, as I heard one the forerunner say, love is what kept Jesus hanging on the cross. And I don't care what your denomination, I don't care what your title, remember that you follow peace with all men. God bless you.
Amen. 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 Give us some praise. Father, we welcome Prophetess Linda Mouton-DeLon. Welcome.
Thank you, Apostle. I just praise God for being here today.
Amen.
The first thing I'd like to do, if it's okay with everybody, is to just make you aware of some upcoming events of To the Glory of God Ministry at 3351 Cable Drive, Suite F. These are Sunday events. Of course, our service is on Saturday evening, 6 o'clock, for those of you who can't make Sunday services. But May 1st, May 15th, and May 22nd, 3 o'clock, all of those Sunday evenings, we have dynamic events going forward. Just inviting you to come by, look at the numbers on the screen, call us, and we'll tell you more about it, because I'm excited about this message for today. You know, there was an opportunity for a man to make $1 million, and the millionaire said to him, if you could give a message with one word that everybody could understand that would help the body of Christ, what would that one word be, and I'll give you $1 million. And he looked at it instantly and said, love. He said, that is the greatest of all things, love. So I want us to recognize that the true fruit of the Spirit is love. But you can't do anything without it. It's a true manifestation of the Spirit.
Yes.
You know, it's a manifestation that we have to recognize that if we're connected, God doesn't ask us to live the perfect life. He says, let the perfect life that we live be through him in us. So if we continue to love, we can walk right. The manifestation is there, and we can do those things that it says, present your body as a living sacrifice. Don't take it back. Don't move off when the altar get hot. Remember, continue to love. And all of the other things that are talked about is the fruit of the Spirit, they'll just naturally flow from you. Amen?
Amen. 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 Praise God. Hallelujah. Now, I know that's a tough act to follow, Apostle Albert DeLon Jr., but amen. Would you at this time tell us a little bit about the fruit of the Spirit? Amen.
Well, everything's been said pretty much today, but I just want to throw a little nugget out, as you said earlier.
Yes.
God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son. And he didn't make a distinction about who's in the world that he loved. He loved everything in the world. But at the second part, he said, those who believe in my Son shall have everlasting life. Now, love is the key to all things. And all I want to say now is that we need to love the sinner and hate the sin.
Come on.
As a church, we need to stop bringing people in the front door and kicking them out the back door.
Mm-hmm.
Because when you love them all the time. You love them for whatever they are.
That's right.
You love them out of the faults. You love them out of the spies of what begin in the head. You see, we so easy and ready to point out people and separate ourselves and click ourselves in, even in the church, mm-hmm. that we need to start loving one another.
That's right.
As we're supposed to love.
That's right.
Because as Apostle Daniel said, it was love that kept Jesus on the cross. So if it can keep him on the cross, it should be able to keep us all together, mm-hmm. loving one another as Jesus would love us.
Amen. Amen. So Pastor Thomas Tucker of Outcast Ministry, would you add a closing note to that? Amen.
Yes, praise well, God. It's very imperative that the church move in love as our brother so wonderfully described. It is very important that love takes place in all dimensions of our lives. Speaking from personal experience, I was lost in the world without Christ. And because I went to a church that accepted me with love, that gave me a chance to change and transform my life. And when they received me with love, then I also received the second fruit of the Spirit, which was joy. Mm. I had great joy that I could go to a place where people would love me unconditionally.
Yes.
And then when I received that joy, when I could go into that church and no one would condemn me, I had peace. I knew that I can go to the church and get prayed for. No one was going to look down on me. No one was going to talk about me. No one was going to downrate me because they knew where the mess I was in or where I was struggling at. And that brings me to the next fruit of the Spirit, which this church had. They had long suffering with me. They was patient with me.
Yes.
And let me tell you something. I used to go to AA and NA class, and they used to tell me, once an alcoholic, always an alcoholic. Mm-hmm. Once a drug head, always a drug head. But let me tell you something. I received the word of God from that church. And they said I was a new creature in Christ, and old things have passed away,
right.
And behold, all things have now become new.
Yes.
So I want you to understand that you are a new creature in Christ. No, you don't have to go to those old clubs telling you, hi, my name is Thomas, a drug head or alcoholic. You've been free, you've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb, and you have the word of God testimony
yes.
with you.
Yes.
Which almost, I'm almost finished here, which bring me to meekness and temperance against things that have no law. They was really kind to me. I want to invite you out to a special service that we're going to be giving to all those who are down and out and trampled down, who having difficulties
yes.
with their children, with things that's happening in their homes. We having a special service, the four dimensions of life, right there in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, at Miracle Faith Church, 9466 Greenwell Springs Drive Road. I want you to come out, bring your whole family. It's a free event, and you're going to be blessed. God bless you, and God keep you now, always, and forever, as you bless each other and walk in love.
Amen. 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 Give the Lord a hand clap for that.
Amen.
And Pastor Tucker, that is in Thibodaux, Louisiana, by the way?
That is in Baton Rouge.
Baton Rouge, Louisiana.
Baton Rouge, right. Louisiana, on the 27th of May.
Amen. Well, I just want to give God some praise for all of our guests.
Amen. Amen.
And I want to thank you, amen, from myself, Apostle Ronnie Bailey, and all of us at Rock of Ages Ministries. And until next time, may God rest, rule, and abide in your life. In Jesus' name, this is my prayer. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God bless you.
We thank you for tuning in today, and on behalf of Apostle Ronnie Bailey and all of our guests here at Rock of Ages Ministries, we hope that you will take these truths expressed on today's telecast and pass it on to others along your life's journey. We also pray that you join with us in taking this message around the world for Jesus. Remember, we can't beat God giving, no matter how hard we try, for the more we give unto Him, the more He'll give back unto us. Now, if you need prayer or counseling, please avail yourselves to our prayer and counseling hotline. The numbers are area code 337-706-7262 or 504-613-7234. If you would like to write us, please send all correspondence to Rock of Ages Ministries, 201 South College Road, Suite 214, Lafayette, Louisiana, 70503. And remember to add your prayer request. Our email address is ronnie@ronniebailey.com, and our website can be accessed anytime at ronniebailey.com. You may also watch our telecast on our brand new webcast channel at www.vo.com/channels/Rock of Ages TV, and enjoy our telecast anytime, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, at your convenience. Now, once again, we thank you for tuning in today. We trust that you've been blessed. Now, until next time, about this same scheduled time, may God bless you. This is our prayer.